What's up, everybody? My name is Brianna Rutter, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you want to prep the base of your hair so that way you can do styles like box braids, poetic justice braids, spring twist, passion twist, the list goes on. I'm going to show you how you want to prep the base of your hair so that you can do individual braids or twists. So when you start off, you want to make sure that your hair is somewhat straight. Now my hair is not bone straight because I did a blowout on my hair a couple of days before I actually did this look. Now you do not have to prep your hair on silky straight, bone straight hair. You just want to make sure that your hair is straight or somewhat straight so that it can actually give you more of a seamless and natural and smooth look with your braids. So now what I'm going to do is I'm using an actual detangling brush and I'm going to brush my hair going back because I want to add some hair growth oil to my edges. Now all of us don't have the fullest of edges. My hair to the naked eye does not look as thin as it does on camera because I do have a lot of light shining on me so you can see everything. But what I like to do for extra measure is make sure that I actually rub in a little bit of edge growth oil to my hairline, especially when I'm putting rubber bands on my hair or any tension on my hair. So as you can see, as I smooth back, this is how my edges look. And honey, I came a long way with my edges. I did a video previously showing you how I actually grew my edges back when I had a little bit of an issue about a year ago with my edges. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how I like to prepare my guidelines. When parting your hair, the most important thing you want to make sure that you do is you actually slightly curve kind of in a half circle going around your head. You're not going to actually part your hair going straight back or straight to the side. The part needs to slightly slant as you go around your head. And also another way to see if your hair is thick enough is you want to take the rat tail comb and you want to part your hair going straight down and you want to kind of eyeball both sides of your square. Your square needs to look pretty even on all sides so that way you know you have a good distance or a good measure for each braid. So I'm using some clips to just hold it in place to give me an idea of how big I want the size of my braids to be. This is a great way for you to first determine how many braids you want on your head before you actually commit by putting rubber bands on your parts. Now, this is not extremely secure because remember, you want to make sure you blow out your hair first or straighten your hair. So that means these clips can somewhat kind of slide a little bit here and there. So if you want to make sure it stays very secure in place, I would suggest that you use butterfly clips instead because there's teeth on those clips so it doesn't move. But as you can see here, it does look pretty secure and this is pretty much the size I want so that I can have the same amount of braids that I want to predict for. Now at this point, I'm going to show you that you want to make sure you're using elastic rubber bands, or they're actually called elastics because there's no rubber in it. Now the difference between elastics and rubber bands is that rubber bands have rubber, which is very tight on the hair and very constricting on the hair, versus elastic is a lot more smooth and stretchier. Rubber bands tend to also break more often than elastics, meaning that it's difficult to keep your style in for the time you would like it to before your rubber band actually pops. So now when it comes to elastic, the only negative drawback I would say is that you have to actually tie it around your part so many times before it's actually secured because it's so stretchy. Another thing too is that when you're doing the rubber band method, as you can see here, when it comes to your braids, is that you don't want to always do this method. When you do this method all the time, it can cause breakage around your rubber banded area where you have short pieces around long pieces. That's because you did the rubber band method a little bit too much. So I will say every other style do the rubber band method, but the rubber band method is literally perfect when you want your style to stay as fresh for as long as possible. So as you can see here, this square is actually a little smaller than my other squares. When you're actually parting your hair, I suggest that you make the squares on the front of your head a little smaller and the squares in the back a little bigger because this adds to more of the illusion of more neater braids on your hair. Now, even at the top, I'm going at a curvature, but my curvature is a little more extreme because I have less area or less hair at the top of my head because we're almost coming to a close. You're going to use some edge control and you're gonna smooth this all around your part, making sure your part is neat before you add your elastic. One little thing that I like to do is I like to press with my finger down on the elastic so that it's as close to my roots as possible and so that it's not too too far up or slipping up the hair, because when you put edge control on your hair or hair gel, it can make your roots just a little bit slippery. So every time I overlap the elastic, I like to press it down with my fingers. Now, as you can see, I'm still following that curvature at the top of my head, so that way I can have squares all the way to the end. But as you can see here, my squares are getting just a little bit smaller, so it can add to more of a natural look near the front. Because usually the front of your head has more finer hair, more thinner hair, you don't want the boxes at the front to be extremely big, unless you kind of have no choice based on how big your actual squares were leading up to it. Now, it's okay if every square is not perfect. You just want the size to be very consistent with neighboring squares. So when you're in the back, the squares are a little bigger, and as you get closer to the front, the squares get a little smaller. That means your rolls will actually get a little thinner as well. So as you can see here, the roll of my hair is a little bit more smaller than it was in the back. And that way, you actually help to follow the consistency of each square as you work your way up the top of your head. As you can see here, you just always want to make sure that you're kind of eyeballing the size right before you actually add your elastic. Now, of course, it's super easy to take the elastics down, but you don't want to keep on adding the elastics, taking it away. You want to have a general idea of where you want your part to be. One thing I like to do is make sure I keep a square at the back so that I can have a cutoff point to how long I want my middle part or side part to be on my head. So as you can see, this is where the cutoff point is, where I have one elastic or one square at the back of my part. So give me a big thumbs up and let me know in the comments what other tutorials y'all would like to see. And by the way, this is how the look turned out. So if you want to see this tutorial, check out my previous videos so I can show you how I achieve these jumbo box braids. And I can't wait to catch y'all in my very next video. Bye bye.